Hey guys, it's Lefty from 643 Productions welcoming you to another Modern Warfare 3 gameplay commentary. Here I am on the map Interchange using the MK14 assault rifle, looking sexy in gold as always. And this gameplay is part of the Quack Clan Revival Tour coming to a Team Deathmatch server near you. And as always, this gameplay is brought to you over some rock and metal music. So go ahead and be sure to drop a like on this video for the unique intros. I am on the verge of having to go get some more new, different metal music because this stuff is, I'm noticing that I'm using it a lot of it because I do upload a video, at least a video every day. So I need to have more in the rotation. But as we fade out this music, I want to talk with you guys about, or continue talking with you about, the Black Ops 2 multiplayer reveal via David Vonderhaar's interview on or with G4TV.com. Now, as I said in my previous video, it's not a huge reveal. And I think that's something that some people might expect going into something like this, and they might come away disappointed because they go into it, right? You go into it thinking, oh man, I can't wait to read about the, you know, what perks are going to be in the game, what guns are going to be in the game, what's going to do what, and how the game is going to be formulated. And this isn't really one of those interviews. It's not a reveal in the sense that Vonderhaar talks about specifics. This is more of a general reveal. This is more revealing of what he and his team at Treyarch wanted to do, and more specifically what they wanted to do differently from the original Black Ops. Now, again, in my first video, I said there were two general points that I wanted to make concerning this interview, one of which was more of a negative tone, which I covered first. I wanted to get that out of the way. And that had to do with the, oh, well, you know, it sounds like this game is going to be kind of pandering again, just like Modern Warfare 3 was, because David Vonderhaar and Robert Bolling were saying very similar things at the onset of the hype machine that was the lead up to their games. Robert Bolling, if you remember, was pretty much saying verbatim what David Vonderhaar says in this interview. Now, moving on from that, I got that point out of my system. I want to pick up a quote midway through the flow of what David Vonderhaar is talking about. Again, with this interview at G4TV.com, the link is in the description. I encourage you to go check it out. But to set up this quote, David Vonderhaar was talking about how the natural progression when creating a sequel is to take what the original was and pretty much copy-paste. He pretty much said, or at least implied, again, he fluffed it up a little bit and he said, oh, well, you know, you got to take, you think, okay, we're taking what works and we're going to add on to that. And that is going to be our sequel. And that is the natural progression, which is basically saying copy-paste. Right? Because that's pretty much, I mean, every Call of Duty developer under Activision's, well, no, not, actually not Treyarch. Treyarch hasn't really done it, because pretty much all of their Call of Duty games in the last 5 or 6 years have been different iterations and different, with different mechanics and different different setups. But okay, so Infinity Ward has been accused of this, but pretty much literally copy pasting mechanics, perks, skins, you know, character models, character model motions, and stuff like that. They have been accused of doing that. And David Vonderhaar is setting up this up by saying, well, you know, that's the natural thing to want to do. And he's here, we'll pick up the quote. He says, quote, but actually, this isn't what we did at all. We actually took a very, very different approach when we were developing multiplayer for Black Ops 2. We actually took the game and we stripped it all down to what's really core. And we've been asking ourselves some really important questions about what is absolutely fundamental to the game. What exists in multiplayer, because it's always existed in multiplayer. And we think that we have to hold on to it because we've had it before. And what is that experience really about? Why are we trying to extend systems when we could just develop the best system? So a lot of core game systems, you know, like a Create a Class, like Killstreaks, have gotten pulled back to where they started from, taking a really critical look, thinking long and hard about which of these cows are sacred, which things are very important and which things are not so important, challenging our assumptions as designers and as franchise makers, what's actually important, end quote. I don't know. I'm going to say this. After reading that quote, and again, you can read it yourself. Go ahead in the description, g4tv.com. The link is down there. After reading that quote, I am really, really excited about Black Ops 2. I know it's probably Von der Haar's ability to hype his own game, and I know it is in the same vein of what Robert Bowling was saying about Modern Warfare 3 pre-Modern Warfare 3. But following David Von der Haar on Twitter and just seeing the kind of... it's hard to explain. Von der Haar has the unique ability that I've found to be almost existential about discussing the game that he is developing. I know I've given him tons of shit before, and, you know, some of it was probably... a lot of it was probably undeserved. But... you know, I have to respect that, because he's like I say, like I like to say, and like I like to encourage others to do, he's letting his nerd hang out. He's letting it all hang out, and he's leaving everything on the table. He's putting it all out there. He's saying, look, I'm a nerd, you're a nerd, let's be really, really, really nerdy about this thing. And I gotta respect that. And the fact that I see it from him in this interview is really, really, really encouraging for Black Ops 2. For me, it's really encouraging, and it actually pumps me up about the title a lot. Let me know in the comments below if that's how you feel. But anyway, guys, that's my time. I gotta get out of here. Thank you for joining. I hope you enjoyed. Be sure to drop a like on this video if you did enjoy, and remember, likes and favorites and shares via Facebook and Twitter do help me out, so don't be shy with the like button. Thank you for joining. I hope you enjoyed. I'm out.